I have been an ardent follower of your books. In fact, even today at my bedside, I have a couple of your books that are there, and I keep reading them because they're very simple stories that you relate so much that you feel you are a part of that story every time you read a new story. And I think that is the beauty. The second reason why I admire you most is because you resemble my mother. I don't mean to say resemble in the physical and personality sense of it, but your humility, your simplicity, and I think is here in the audience also watching this. And of course, you're an engineer by training and by profession. You work for telco. We all know your story. Likewise, my mother did her MSc. She was actually doing her PhD in zoology. But to just take care of the family and take care, of course, of the important decisions taken by your husband when many people don't even know that very critical decisions in Infosys. I'm sure you're a part of it, like what my mother is a part of Symbiosys. There is so much resemblance, and I just admire this simplicity and humility. And I wish all of us, as young, I won't say girls, but women, grow up to become like you. So I don't think I'm going to be, come in between, all the talks by eminent people like my father himself and you. But just that today is a very, very memorable day, and the kind of work that you have been doing. So one of many of our Symbiosis alumni are working with you, madam, in Infosys and Infosys Foundation, specifically Padma, whom I was interacting with. And she asked me what topic should madam speak on, and I just felt it should be joy of giving, because this is a topic that I'm sure is close to your heart. The amount of things that you have done through the foundation, and so many boys and girls being inspired by the several thousands of libraries that you have set up. I think it's an amazing work. And we, in our little way, of course, education is a charitable purpose, and therefore not only the educational institution that we've set up, but we are in a village called Lavde, the main university campus of 300 acres on the outskirts of Pune. And what we have done is we have adopted 22 villages around our university campus, and we do work in education. We educate young girls who come from the poorest of families. We do a lot of work in healthcare. We have a mobile clinic that goes around in these villages and wadis and provides all the medical treatment. And of course, other areas of sanitation, etc. We have just set up a Symbiosis Medical College for girls specifically. And again, it was Muzumdar sir's idea to empower girls, and therefore we set it up. And along with that, a 900-bedded hospital, which is run totally free, just the wing, which is a paid wing, small wing, but the rest of the hospital, almost 700 beds with OPD, any treatment is given totally free, because sir believes that after 50 years, it is time to give back to the society. Just last week, I had an excellent meeting with Infosys Foundation and CSR people, Padma, Thiru, and Kiran. And I realized that there is so much in common between what Symbiosis does and Infosys does. And I'm sure I'm really looking forward to some kind of collaboration, especially in this community outreach work that we are doing and you are doing, madam. So with these few words, I welcome you once again to the Golden Jubilee Lecture, and I hope this association grows further, strength by strength. Thank you.